Hi YouTube friends, it's Megan Tilly here with AM Soaps, and today I'm making a soap fragranced with coffee beans. This has 1% vanilla in it, so I'm going to work with the vanillin in my design. And I will be putting actual coffee grounds in a portion of the batter. Now this is a blend of coffee grounds that have been used and coffee grounds that have not been used. I like the properties of both, so I decided to blend it. I have my favorite piping tip, which is the Wilton 8B piping tip, and it's nice, has nice strong design to it, it's just like structured lines, and it's quite large, which is good for putting piping on soap, using soap batter. I have embeds for the top, which are, these were made in chocolate, a hot cocoa fragrance. Quite a while ago when I made a chocolate soap, I also made these embeds. I have these hearts, and these are actually melt and pour. They're tiny coffee beans that will go on top of the soap as well. And my heart, which is my signature, today will be pink. Before I start, I always check temperatures. I have 80.9 degrees on my lye water blend and 78.8 on my oils. So I will go ahead and blend this up. This is going to be a no color, no fragrance batter. And it is a contrast. It's going to be a bit of contrast to the brown that the vanilla will create. I want this to look like a latte. So I'm going to have two blends of batter with the fragrance, one with grounds, one with not, without grounds, and they're going to be drop swirled, and this is going to be drop swirled into the top, and then it's going to lead up to the piped topping to have a latte appearance. What I do when I am leaving batter to thicken up for piping is I put it in Ziploc sandwich bags. And that way you don't have to be getting thick batter out from a container and into the piping bag. You just put the bag in upside down in the piping bag. And this becomes kind of a bag in a bag. It's just a really simple time saver that I have been using for, I believe, at least 2 years. I've put aside too much, I think. There we go. So this is what I'm going to put aside for my piping. I like piping the tops of my soaps because I like the look of the foodie look. You know, I like the shapes of the piping containers, and it makes people smile. Gives everything a touch of whimsy. The most annoying thing people say to me, I'm sorry, I love my customers, but the most annoying is, it looks too good to use. I don't really understand that. Surely you could use a soap that looks like a piece of fudge. This is the next batch, and this is 4 pounds of batter, 82 degrees on the lye water and 79 degrees on the blend of oils that I have set. And I'm going to add this in here. And I'm going to leave this Pyrex aside to use when I portion off the batter. Now this won't quite add up because this is a 4 pound mold, because I have one, I always use 1 pound for topping. I've had this question before. People ask, how do you know how much batter to leave for the topping? So we'll do a kind of back calculation. How much higher do you want the soap to be than it is? For example, I want my soap to be 1/4 higher or 25% higher than it appears without the topping. So then you need, I have 4 pound batch of of soap, I need to make 1 pound for the topping to add that 25% extra. So you look at it as from the side of the bar and just one bar rather than the whole blend. How much bigger do I want this one bar? That's how much more batter you need to have topping. And it's the exact same recipe I use for the topping as the rest of the soap. I also almost always mix samples. So if I have extra batter and you see me pouring and I didn't empty the container, that's because behind me I am going to be pouring into another container for samples. I like to give my customers samples. Often it's a gift because they bought something else, or it might be because they come and they look at something, for example, my dish soap, and they're kind of wary, like they'll come and look at it and I can tell they're interested, but they're unsure and they don't know. Do they want to spend $5 on something they're not sure about? And I'll give them a sample. Might be, some people might think it's foolish, otherwise, I'm not sure, but I've been doing this for years and it's been working well for me. People do come back to purchase and they appreciate getting the trial. In the age of information, most people won't buy things without either a review or getting to try it first. Now I'm going to add in the coffee grounds to this batter. And for, it is unfortunate that you can't smell through YouTube because this smells, I love coffee, and this smells like the best cup of coffee ever. It smells like a really good cup of coffee. Dark roast, made perfect. In fact, while I'm waiting for the piping to thicken up, I'm actually going to make some coffee. This has inspired me to sit and have a cup of coffee in the afternoon. Today is a Friday. In the summertime, I get Fridays off from work. We work extra hours all year, shorter lunches, to be able to have Fridays off. We call them sunny Fridays. And it's one of the things I love the most about my job. For 10 years, I had another job where I always had Fridays off. So it's hard to come to a Monday to Friday job from that. And I always just remember that sunny Fridays will return, just hang in there, and here they are. June, July, and August is when I have Fridays off. And then I really like to make soap on a Friday. And I can cut it on Saturday and edit the video for you to post for Monday. I'm just going to pour in this batter that has fragrance but no coffee grounds and pour in quite a lot of it. There we go. Put that aside. Now I have the batch of coffee grounds. These are pretty fluid, so I'm going to just pause for a minute and let these thicken up before I pour this in because I want this to be a drop swirl. That's not wispy, but a thicker swirl. So I'm just gonna give this a moment and I'll be right back. I'm back now. I just gave this a few minutes to thicken up a little bit. And I'm going to pour my coffee grounds blend into the other one. And I'm not going to chopstick this or anything. I'm just gonna let the swirls do what they do, whatever they want to do here. Next is the batter with no fragrance and no color. And I just give it some wispies here. Pour in so a little bit of that will drop to give me a poured in steamed milk look like a latte. Now is the time to put in my heart. So I have pink hearts here. This is from a column mold. And I just place my hearts in. There is a reason for my hearts. I've mentioned it in other videos. I put a signature heart in every soap, and it is related to basically a house fire that we had. We had a house lost in a forest fire, and the fundraising campaign used a logo with heart in it like this, and I've been putting hearts in my soap ever since. And then our motto for our company is soaps made with heart, because every soap, almost every soap, has a little heart. And first, I'm going to cover my heart. And then beside, over here. And then the next layer will be the piped topping. And it will be the same batter with no fragrance, no color. And it will finish off the cafe latte look to the soap with my chocolate looking finishes. And when I pipe this, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about what happened to me last weekend. I had a sort of a bad experience at a craft show. I'll let you know what happened in a minute when we pipe the soap. So here is my batter for piping. It is not as thick as I would like it to be. However, I do have to be somewhere, so I'm gonna have to just put this in the piping bag and do the best I can with it. And I'll tell you what I wanted to talk about, which is a craft show I went to last weekend. And besides making soap, I also make dolls. Well, I paint. I'm a painter. And I paint on wood, and I paint nested dolls and what's called peg dolls. And I've been doing that for a few years. One day I tried it, and I found that it made people really happy. They enjoyed my work, so I kept doing it. And this year, I decided to go to a Ukrainian festival with my dolls. They're nested dolls, and I know that Ukrainian people love them. They're Russian, Ukrainian. They actually came originally from China and Japan. And I was kind of worried about the festival. I thought that people might not think I was Ukrainian enough. And I thought that that might be a bit of a problem at the festival. And, people might give me a hard time over not being, 100% Ukrainian. But that was not my problem. My problem was when I signed up for the festival, I was asked a simple question, and I thought about it literally for 10 seconds and gave my answer. And the question was, do I want to be at the festival with the vendors or with the artists? And really, I gave it very little thought. I said artists. It wasn't something I thought about too much, and I never thought it would be a problem. I am a painter. And I have done many art shows, so I have no problem calling myself an artist. However, what happened was what I make is folk art, and I know that. I have a doll here, so I'll show you an example. Here, she's under here. This is one of my, this one has a bell. And see the face I'm working on? She's, maybe 20% done. So I do some base colors and designs, and I spend a lot of time and care on this face. The eyes are very important. So, I know it's folk art. It does require some skill and experience to make the pretty doll face on my dolls. Most of the dolls you'll find mass-produced have really ugly faces. So that's my goal, is that my faces are pretty and I'm proud of my dolls. One of the vendors, instead of going to the organizers, started talking, Instead of going to the organizers, she started talking about me to the other artists. And I overheard her saying that I am not an artist and I should not be with them in that part of the festival. And I overheard it and I didn't know she was talking about me. She was saying the words, that's not art. I felt she's probably talking about me. It didn't occur to me. I'd forgotten that there is a snobby part of the art community. I've spent a lot of my life in it, so I've come across it and experienced it. I just totally forgotten about them. So my problem with the weekend wasn't so much that she had her opinion, but that instead of her talking to the organizer about it, I should have 12 bars here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. She felt she had to talk to other people there about it. And she did that on, there was a 3-day festival. She did that on the second day of the festival. So I really spent the last day, I just wanted to go home. I didn't enjoy it. This woman really ruined the whole festival for me in the end. I wanted to go home and I had my thoughts like, I'm not coming back here. I'm not wanted. And I thought, well, if I come back, I'll say vendor next time. I made this critical mistake of saying artist because I've offended the true artist. She actually never, this woman that took offense to me being there, had never come to see my work when I was there. She probably did come by when I was not at the table. She didn't want much to do with me. She just gave me looks like she was disgusted that I exist. So my question really came up in life. What is art? I try not to. I think pride is something, like, you should be proud of yourself, but you need to be a humble person, and being all snobby about being an artist to me is not a good attribute to have as a human being. I don't care if I join the vendors. I'm sure I will next year. And so that is my one, you know, what is art? Who do people think they are? Say that they know who's an artist and what is art, and it takes creativity and hard work and talent. Some of it you are born with. I know that. When I was a child, really, I spent a large portion of my childhood drawing. I was born with the desire to draw. So I was born with that. But my parents didn't encourage it. It's just something I did. And my other question about it all is gossiping and communicating. Why didn't the others just shut her down? I did overhear them say that is art. They did defend me, but why do people feel comfortable being like that? We're adults. Like, this person was a senior. In her life, she's gotten to the point where she's a senior and she still feels she can gossip. This question of hers needed to go to the organizers. And not in front of me and not in front of anyone. They send out a survey. Put it in your survey. Say you think that maybe art submissions should be juried and someone should decide who gets to be in with the artists. A comment like that, right? Maybe we should have to submit a portfolio before we can be there. could backfire and they tell her she's not welcome there. And just fitting in general, like a friend of mine asked me how it went, and I told her, you know what, they didn't, I just felt like no one liked me. And she said, well, that's happened to her at other shows. She said, it happens. Happened to her mother, and it's happened to her. And when you have a group of people, seems to be women very often, who know each other and have been, you know, they're a little groupie, like little clique. They're just not nice to you. Some of them were nice to me, but I don't know. I was knitting, and I always bring something to do because I don't sit still well. I need to move around or do something. So I always bring crochet or knitting. Reading, I can't, you know, get into reading because you're looking out for customers. So I bring crocheting or knitting and enjoy myself. This is the first show I've been to where no one else was knitting. I was the only one knitting. A couple people asked me, like, why are you knitting? I said, oh, well, you know, I have another soap business. I'm making washcloths for my soap business. Well, aren't you clever? Comments like that. And I was like, oh, I guess knitting's not the thing here. And people are asking me like I'm some kind of weirdo for working on a project while I was there. My other comment is that I am a soap maker and an artist, and I work full-time, and I help with my husband's auction business. So I have a full-time job and 3 side hustles. And lately, I see myself as a business person. And part of my business is to be smart about how I paint. Like, for example, I've got her that I will spend 100 hours on, this little doll. And then I'll have another doll that I can do in one evening. You spend 4 hours on it. However, people desire both the simple doll and the complex doll. And I put them on the shelves for the same amount of money. It's a business decision to make up my money by having both styles. And I think that's what offended her, was I had some simple designs on my table along with the complex designs. But this is the reason. I work full time. I need to get inventory. People love those ones just as much as these ones. And I'm a business person as well as an artist. I don't think that was understood. I just had a bad weekend, basically. But here we are, talking over a coffee soap. And I will cut this tomorrow, and we'll have a look at what it looks like on the inside. And it's also going to have to sit for a few days to darken up to what it will really look like. So we'll see how that looks later.